This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. An Indian reservation is a legal designation for an area of land managed by a Native American tribe under the U.S. Bureau of Indian Affairs, rather than the state governments of the United States in which they are physically located. Each of the 326 Indian reservations in the United States are associated with a particular nation. Not all of the country's 567 recognized tribes have a reservation. Some tribes have more than one reservation, some share reservations, while others have none in addition, because of past land allotments, leading to some sales to non-Native Americans. Some reservations are severely fragmented, with each piece of tribal, individual, and privately held land being a separate enclave. This jumble of private and public real estate creates significant administrative, political, and legal difficulties. The collective geographical area of all reservations is 56,200,000 acres, 22,700,000. Vary from the surrounding area. These laws can permit legal casinos on reservations, for example, which attract tourists. The tribal council, not the local or federal government, generally has jurisdiction over reservations. Different reservations have different systems of government, which may or may not replicate the forms of government found outside the reservation. Most Native American reservations were established by the federal government. A limited number, mainly in the East, owe their origin to state recognition. The name reservation comes from the conception of the Native American tribes as independent sovereigns at the time the U.S. Constitution was ratified. Thus, the early peace treaties often signed under duress in which Native American tribes surrendered large portions of land to the U.S. also designated parcels which the tribes, as sovereigns, reserved to themselves, and those parcels came to be called reservations. The term remained in use even after the federal government began to forcibly relocate tribes to parcels of land to which they had no historical connection. A majority of Native Americans and Alaska Natives live somewhere other than the reservations, often in big western cities such as Phoenix and Los Angeles. In 2012, there were over 25 million Native Americans, with about 1 million living on reservations. Contents 1 History 11 Colonial and Early U.S. History 12 Rise of Indian Removal Policy 1830-1868-13 Forced Assimilation 1868-1887-14 Individualized Reservations 1887-1934-15 Indian New Deal 1934 Present 2 Land Tenure and Federal Indian Law 3 Life and Culture 4 Gambling 5 Law Enforcement and Crime 51 Violence and Substance Abuse 6 See also 7 References 8 Further Reading 9 External links. History Colonial and Early U.S. History. This section needs expansion. You can help by adding to it. November 2014. From the beginning of the European colonization of the Americas, Europeans often removed native peoples from lands they wished to occupy. The means varied, including voluntary moves based on mutual agreement, treaties made under considerable duress, forceful ejection, and violence. The removal caused many problems, such as tribes losing means of livelihood by being subjected to a defined area, farmers having inadmissible land for agriculture, and hostility between tribes. On March 11, 1824, John C. Calhoun founded the Office of Indian Affairs, now the Bureau of Indian Affairs, as a division of the U.S. Department of War, now the Department of Defense, to solve the land problem with 38 treaties with American Indian tribes. Rise of Indian Removal Policy 1830-1868 Main article, Indian Removal. The passage of the Indian Removal Act of 1830 marked the systematization of a U.S. federal government policy of forcibly moving native populations away from European populated areas. One example was the five civilized tribes, who were removed from their native lands in the southern United States and moved to modern-day Oklahoma, in a mass migration that came to be known as the Trail of Tears. Some of the lands these tribes were given to inhabit following the removals eventually became Indian reservations. In 1851, the United States Congress passed the Indian Appropriations Act, which authorized the creation of Indian reservations in modern-day Oklahoma. Relations between settlers and natives had grown increasingly worse as the settlers encroached on territory and natural resources in the West. Forced assimilation 1868-1887 Most Indian reservations, like the Laguna Indian Reservation in New Mexico pictured here in 1943, are in the western United States, often in regions suitable more for ranching than farming. In 1868, President Ulysses S. Grant pursued a peace policy as an attempt to avoid violence, the policy included a reorganization of the Indian Service, with the goal of relocating various tribes from their ancestral homes to parcels of lands established specifically for their inhabitation. The policy called for the replacement of government officials by religious men, nominated by churches, to oversee the Indian agencies on reservations in order to teach Christianity to the native tribes. The Quakers were especially active in this policy on reservations. The policy was controversial from the start. Reservations were generally established by executive order in many cases. White settlers objected to the size of land parcels, which were subsequently reduced. A report submitted to Congress in 1868 found widespread corruption among the federal Native American agencies and generally poor conditions among the relocated tribes. Many tribes ignored the relocation orders at first and were forced onto their limited land parcels. Enforcement of the policy required the United States Army to restrict the movements of various tribes. The pursuit of tribes in order to force them back onto reservations led to a number of Native American massacres and some wars. The most well-known conflict was the Sioux War on the northern Great Plains, between 1876 and 1881, which included the Battle of Little Bighorn. Other famous wars in this regard included the Nez Perce War. By the late 1870s, the policy established by President Grant was regarded as a failure, primarily because it had resulted in some of the bloodiest wars between Native Americans and the United States. By 1877, President Rutherford B. Hayes began phasing out the policy, and by 1882 all religious organizations had relinquished their authority to the Federal Indian Agency. Individualized reservations, 1887-1934. In 1887, Congress undertook a significant change in reservation policy by the passage of the Dawes Act, or General Allotment Severalty Act. The act ended the general policy of granting land parcels to tribes as a whole by granting small parcels of land to individual tribe members in some cases, for example the Umatilla Indian Reservation. After the individual parcels were granted out of reservation land, the reservation area was reduced by giving the excess land to white settlers. The individual allotment policy continued until 1934, when it was terminated by the Indian Reorganization Act. Indian New Deal 1934 present. The Indian Reorganization Act of 1934, also known as the Howard Wheeler Act, was sometimes called the Indian New Deal. It laid out new rights for Native Americans, reversed some of the earlier privatization of their common holdings, and encouraged tribal sovereignty and land management by tribes. The act slowed the assignment of tribal lands to individual members, and reduced the assignment of extra holdings to non-members for the following 20 years. The U.S. government invested in infrastructure, health care, and education on the reservations, and over 2 million acres, 8,000. California lost their federal recognition as tribes. Many individuals were also relocated to cities, but one-third returned to their tribal reservations in the decades that followed land tenure and federal Indian law. With the establishment of reservations, tribal territories diminished to a fraction of original areas, and indigenous customary practices of land tenure sustained only for a time, and not in every instance. Instead, the federal government established regulations that subordinated tribes to the authority, first, of the military, and then of the Bureau Office of Indian Affairs. Under federal law, the government patented reservations to tribes, which became legal entities that at later times have operated in a corporate manner. Tribal tenure identifies jurisdiction over land use planning and zoning, negotiating with the close participation of the Bureau of Indian Affairs. Leases for timber harvesting and mining. Tribes generally have authority over other forms of economic development such as ranching, agriculture, tourism, and casinos. Tribes hire both members, other Indians and non-Indians in varying capacities. They may run tribal stores, gas stations, and develop museums. E.g., there is a gas station and general store at Fort Hall Indian Reservation, Idaho, and a museum at Foxwoods, on the Mashantucket Pequot Indian Reservation in Connecticut. Tribal members may utilize a number of resources held in tribal tenure, such as grazing range and some cultivable lands. They may also construct homes on tribally held lands. As such, members are tenants in common, which may be likened to communal tenure. But keep in mind, even if some of this pattern emanates from pre-reservation tribal custom, generally the tribe has the authority to modify tenant-in-common practices. Wagon loaded with squash, Rosebud Indian Reservation, CA 1936. With the General Allotment Act, Dawes, 1887, the government sought to individualize tribal lands by authorizing allotments held in individual tenure. Generally, the allocation process led to grouping family holdings and, in some cases, this sustained pre-reservation clan or other patterns. There had been a few allotment programs ahead of the Dawes Act, but the vast fragmentation of reservations occurred from enactment of this act up to 1934, when the Indian Reorganization Act was passed. However, Congress authorized some allotment programs in the ensuing years, such as on the Palm Springs, Agua Caliente Indian Reservation in California. Allotment set in motion a number of circumstances. Individuals could sell alienate the allotment. Under the Dawes Act, it was not to happen until after 25 years. Individual allots who would die intestate would encumber the land under prevailing state devisement laws, leading to complex patterns of heirship. Congress has attempted to mollify the impact of heirship by granting tribes the capacity to acquire fragmented allotments owing to heirship by financial grants. Tribes may also include such parcels in long-range land use planning with alienation to non-Indians. Their increased presence on numerous reservations has changed the demography of Indian country. One of many implications of this fact is that tribes can not always effectively embrace the total management of a reservation. For non-Indian owners and users of allotted lands contend that tribes have no authority over lands that fall within the tax and law and order jurisdiction of local government. The demographic factor, coupled with landownership data, led, for example, to litigation between the Devil's Lake Sioux and the state of North Dakota, where non-Indians owned more acreage than tribal members even though more Native Americans resided on the reservation than non-Indians. The court decision turned, in part, on the perception of Indian character, contending that the tribe did not have jurisdiction over the alienated allotments in a number of instances, e.g., the Yakima Indian Reservation. Tribes have identified open and closed areas within reservations. One finds the majority of non-Indian landownership and residence in the open areas, and, contrarywise, closed areas represent exclusive tribal residence and related conditions. Spring roundup of Paiute-owned cattle begins at Pyramid Lake Indian Reservation. 1973 Indian country today consists of tripartite government, i.e., federal, state and or local, and tribal, where state and local governments may exert some, but limited, law and order authority. Tribal sovereignty is, of course, diminished. This situation prevails in connection with Indian gaming, since federal legislation makes the state a party to any contractual or statutory agreement. Finally, other occupancy on reservations may be by virtue of tribal or individual tenure. There are many churches on reservations. Most would occupy tribal land by consent of the federal government or the tribe via agency offices, hospitals, schools, and other facilities usually occupy residual federal parcels within reservations. Many reservations include one or more sections, about 640 acres of school lands, but those lands typically remain part of the reservation, e.g., Enabling Act of 1910 at Section 20. As a general practice, such lands may sit idle or be grazed by tribal ranchers. Life and culture. See also, Modern Social Statistics of Native Americans. This section does not cite any sources. Please help improve this section by adding citations to reliable sources. Unsourced material may be challenged and removed. March 2012. Learn how and when to remove this template message. Red Cliff Indian Reservation in Wisconsin during their annual powwow. Many Native Americans who live on reservations deal with the federal government through two agencies, the Bureau of Indian Affairs and the Indian Health Service. The quality of life on some reservations is comparable to that in the developing world, with issues of infant mortality, life expectancy, malnutrition and poverty, and alcohol and drug abuse. The two poorest counties in the United States are Buffalo County, South Dakota, home of the Lower Brule Indian Reservation, and Oglala Lakota County, South Dakota, home of the Pine Ridge Indian Reservation. According to data compiled by the 2000 Census Gambling main article, Native American Gaming in 1979, the Seminole Tribe in Florida opened a high-stakes bingo operation on its reservation in Florida. The state attempted to close the operation down but was stopped in the courts in the 1980s. The case of California v. Cabazon Band of Mission Indians established the right of reservations to operate other forms of gambling operations. In 1988, Congress passed the Indian Gaming Regulatory Act, which recognized the right of Native American tribes to establish gambling and gaming facilities on their reservations as long as the states in which they are located have some form of legalized gambling. Today, many Native American casinos are used as tourist attractions, including as the basis for hotel and conference facilities, to draw visitors and revenue to reservations. Successful Gaming operations on some reservations have greatly increased the economic wealth of some tribes, enabling their investment to improve infrastructure, education and health for their people. Law enforcement and crime. Serious crime on Indian reservations has historically been required by the 1885 Major Crimes Act, 18 U.S.C. sections 1153, 3242, and court decisions to be investigated by the federal government, usually the Federal Bureau of Investigation, and prosecuted by United States Attorneys of the United States Federal Judicial District in which the reservation lies. Tribal courts were limited to sentences of 1 year or less, until on July 29, 2010 the Tribal Law and Order Act was enacted, which in some measure reforms the system, permitting tribal courts to impose sentences of up to 3 years provided proceedings are recorded and additional rights are extended to defendants. The Justice Department on January 11, 2010 initiated the Indian Country Law Enforcement Initiative, which recognizes problems with law enforcement on Indian reservations and assigns top priority to solving existing problems. The Department of Justice recognizes the unique legal relationship that the United States has with federally recognized tribes as one aspect of this relationship. In much of Indian country, the Justice Department alone has the authority to seek a conviction that carries an appropriate potential sentence when a serious crime has been committed. Our role as the primary prosecutor of serious crimes makes our responsibility to citizens in Indian country unique and mandatory accordingly. Public safety in tribal communities is a top priority for the Department of Justice. Emphasis was placed on improving prosecution of crimes involving domestic violence and sexual assault, passed in 1953. Public Law 280, PETA Leaders 280, gave jurisdiction over criminal offenses involving Indians in Indian country to certain states and allowed other states to assume jurisdiction. Subsequent legislation allowed states to retrocede jurisdiction, which has occurred in some areas. Some Place 280 reservations have experienced jurisdictional confusion, tribal discontent, and litigation, compounded by the lack of data on crime rates and law enforcement response. As of 2012, a high incidence of rape continued to impact Native American women. Violence and substance abuse. Further information: American Indian Alcoholism and Methamphetamine and Native Americans. A survey of death certificates over a four-year period showed that deaths among Indians due to alcohol are about four times as common as in the general U.S. population and are often due to traffic collisions and liver disease, with homicide, suicide, and falls. Also contributing deaths due to alcohol among American Indians are more common in men and among Northern Plains Indians. Alaska Natives showed the least incidence of death. Alcohol abuse by Native Americans has been shown to be associated with development of disease, including pneumonia, tuberculosis, liver problems, and pancreatitis, as well as hearing and vision problems, kidney and bladder problems, head injuries, sprains and muscle strains, and dental problems. Gang violence is becoming a major social problem. A December 13, 2009, The New York Times article about growing gang violence on the Pine Ridge Indian Reservation estimated that there were 39 gangs with 5,000 members on that reservation alone. See also Hawaiian Homeland Indian Claims Commission. Indian Colony. Indian Country. List of historical Indian reservations in the United States. List of Indian reservations in the United States. Native American reservation. Politics. Reservation. Poverty. Reservations in Nebraska. International Rancheria. Ranchery term used in British Columbia. Indigenous protected area in Australia. Native community lands in Bolivia. Indigenous territory. Brazil. Indian reserve in Canada. Indigenous territory. Colombia. Indigenous territories of Costa Rica. References. Carrot. ABCD. Frequently asked questions. Bureau of Indian Affairs. Department of the Interior. Retrieved 8 August 2015. Carrot. Davies. P.P. Updated November 21, 2007. Carat. Expansion of Tribal Courts Authority passes Senate. Article by Michael Riley in the Denver Post, posted the 25th of June 2010, 1:00:00 a.m. MDT. Updated the 25th of June 2010, 2:13:47 a.m. MDT. Accessed June 25, 2010. Carat. President Obama signs Tribal Justice Changes. Article by Michael Riley in the Denver Post, posted the 30th of July. 2010, 1:00:00 a.m. MDT. Updated the 30th of July 2010, 6:00:20 a.m. MDT. Accessed July 30, 2010. Carat. Memorandum for United States Attorneys with districts containing Indian country. Memorandum by David W. Ogden, Deputy Attorney General. Monday, January 11, 2010. Accessed August 12, 2010. Carat. Public Law 280 and Law Enforcement in Indian Country. Research priority. priorities December 2005, accessed August 12, 2010 Timothy Williams May 22, 2012 for Native American Women, Scourge of Rape, Rare Justice The New York Times retrieved May 23, 2012. Conditions J. Shore, M.D., M.Ph., University of Colorado Health Sciences Center March 26, 2006, accessed October 7, 2009 Gang Violence on the Rise on Indian Reservations NPR, National Public Radio August 25, 2009 Indian Gangs Grow, Bringing Fear and Violence to Reservation The New York Times December 13, 2009 Further reading J.P. Allen and E. Turner, Changing Faces, Changing Places, Mapping Southern California's Northridge, CA, the Center for Geographical Studies, California State University, Northridge, 2002 George Pierre Castle and Robert L. B., eds., State and Reservation, New Perspectives on Federal Indian Policy Tucson, University of Arizona Press, 1992 Richmond L. Klo and Imra Sutton, eds., Trusteeship in Change, Toward Tribal Autonomy in Resource Management Boulder, University Press of Colorado, 2001 Wade Davies and Richmond L. Klo, American Indian Sovereignty and Law, an Annotated Bibliography Lanham, M.D., Scarecrow Press, 2009 T.J. Ferguson and E. Richard Hart, A Zuni Atlas Norman, University of Oklahoma Press, 1985. David H. Getches, Charles F. Wilkinson, and Robert A. Williams, Cases and Materials on Federal Indian Law, 4th ed. St. Paul, West Group, 1998 Klaus Franz, Indian Reservations in the United States, Geography Research Paper 241 Chicago, University of Chicago Press, 1999 James M. Goodman, The Navajo Atlas, Environments, Resources, People, and History of the Diné Baikia Norman, University of Oklahoma Press, 1982 J.P. Kinney, A Continent Lost, A Civilization Won, Indian Land Tenure in America Baltimore, Johns Hopkins University Press, 1937 Francis Paul Prucha, Atlas of American Indian Affairs Norman, University of Nebraska Press, 1990 C.C. Royce, Comp, Indian Land Sessions in the United States, 18th Annual Report, 1896-97, P.T. 2 Wash, D.C., Bureau of American Ethnology, G.P.O. 1899 Imra Sutton, Cartographic Review of Indian Land Tenure and Territoriality, A Schematic Approach, American Indian Culture and Research Journal, 26-2-2002-63-113 Imra Sutton, Indian Land Tenure, Bibliographical Essays and a Guide to the Literature NY, Clearwater PUBL 1975 Imra Sutton, ed., The Political Geography of Indian Country, American Indian Culture and Resource Journal, 152-1-169 1991. Imra Sutton, Sovereign States and the Changing Definition of the Indian Reservation, Geographical Review, 66-3-1976-281-295 Veronica E. Velarde Tiller, ed., Tiller's Guide to Indian Country, Economic Profiles of American Indian Reservations Albuquerque, Boero Pub, 1996-2005 David J. Wishart and Oliver Froling, Land Ownership, Population and Jurisdiction, The Case of the Devil's Lake Sioux Tribe v. North Dakota Public Service Commission, American Indian Culture and Research Journal, 202-33-58 1996 Laura Woodward Ney, Mapping Identity, The Coeur d'Alene Indian Reservation, 1803-1902 Boulder, University Press of Colorado, 2004 External links Wikimedia Commons has media related to Indian reservations BIA Full-size map of Indian reservations in the continental United States BIA Index to map of Indian reservations in the Continental United States U.S. Census Tallies for Indian Reservations Chapter 5, American Indian and Alaska Native Areas, U.S. Census Bureau, Geographic Areas Reference Manual PDF FEMA, Federally Recognized Indian Reservations. Tribal Leaders Directory Wheeler Howard Act Indian Reorganization Act 1934 Native American Technical Corrections Act of 2003 Gambling on the Reservation April 2004 Christian Science Monitor article with links to other Monitor articles on the topic Henry Red Cloud of Oglala Lakota Tribe on the Recession's Toll on Reservations, video report by Democracy Now! Tribal Justice and Safety. Gov. U.S. Department of Justice website devoted to Indian issues. Public Law 280 and Law Enforcement in Indian Country, Research Priorities. Indian Land Cession by Years v. Aboriginal Title in the United States Statutes. Colonial Era Charter of Freedoms and Exemptions 1629. New Netherland Royal Proclamation of 1763. British North America Confederation Congress Proclamation of 1783. United States Northwest Ordinance 1787. Non-Intercourse Act 1790, 1793, 1796, 1799, 1802, and 1834. Removal Act 1830. Dawes Act 1887. Diminishment Curtis Act of 1898. Reorganization Act 1934. Indian Claims Commission Act 1946. Indian Land Claims Settlements 1978-2006. Indian Claims Limitations Act 1982. Precedents Marshall Court, Johnson v. Montash 1823. Cherokee Nation v. Georgia 1831. Taney Court, Fellows v. Blacksmith 1857. New York ex rel. Cutler v. Dibble 1858. 1890-1950. Seneca Nation of Indians v. Christie 1896. United States v. Santa Fe Pacific Railroad Co. 1941. Warren Court, Tehit-Tun Indians v. United States 1955. Federal Power Commission v. Tuscarora Indian Nation 1960. Burger Court, Oneida Indian Nation of New York v. County of Oneida 1974. Wilson v. Omaha Indian Tribe 1979. County of Oneida v. Oneida Indian Nation of New York State 1985. South Carolina v. Catawba Indian Tribe 1986. Rehnquist Court, Idaho v. Coeur d'Alene Tribe of Idaho 1997. Idaho v. United States 2001. City of Sherrill v. Oneida Indian Nation of New York 2005. By State Alaska California. Hawaii, Indiana, Louisiana, Maine, Michigan, New Mexico, New York, Oklahoma, Rhode Island, Vermont. Compare Indigenous Land Rights. Aboriginal Title in Australia. Tribal Sovereignty in the United States. List of federally recognized tribes. Federal recognition of Native Hawaiians. Legal status of Hawaii. VE Political divisions of the United States. States: Alabama, Alaska, Arizona, Arkansas, California, Colorado, Connecticut, Delaware, Florida, Georgia, Hawaii, Idaho, Illinois, Indiana, Iowa, Kansas, Kentucky, Louisiana, Maine, Maryland, Massachusetts, Michigan, Minnesota, Mississippi, Missouri, Montana, Nebraska, Nevada, New Hampshire, New Jersey, New Mexico, New York, North Carolina, North Dakota, Ohio, Oklahoma, Oregon, Pennsylvania, Rhode Island, South Carolina, South Dakota, Tennessee, Texas, Utah, Vermont, Virginia, Washington, West Virginia, Wisconsin, Wyoming, Federal District, Washington, D.C. Insular Areas, American Samoa, Guam, Northern Mariana Islands, Puerto Rico, U.S. Virgin Islands, Outlying Islands, Baker Island, Howland Island, Jarvis Island, Johnston Atoll, Kingman Reef, Midway Atoll, Navassa Island, Palmyra Atoll, Wake Island, Indian Reservations. List of Indian Reservations. Largest Associated States. Federated States of Micronesia. Marshall Islands. Palau v. United States Census. Geography. Regional. Region. Division. State. District of Columbia, Puerto Rico, Insular Area, American Samoa, Guam, Northern Mariana Islands, U.S. Virgin Islands, Zip Code, Tabulation Area, Native Areas, Legal, Alaska, Native Regional Corporation, American Indian Reservation List, American Indian Tribal Subdivision, Hawaiian Homeland Off Reservation Trust Land, Statistical Alaska, Native Village Statistical Area, Oklahoma Tribal Statistical Area, Joint Use Area, State Designated Tribal Statistical Areas, Tribal Designated Statistical Area, Metropolitan Primary Statistical Area, 574 PSAs, Combined Statistical Area, 169 CSAs, Core Based Statistical Area, 929 CBSAs, Metropolitan Statistical Area, 388 MSAs, Micropolitan Statistical Area, 541 MU/SAS, New England City and Town Area, Urban Area, 497 urbanized areas and urban clusters, state level congressional district county, 3,143 counties and equivalents, Alaska Census Area, Independent City, Municipio Place Census Designated Public Use Microdata Area, School District List, State Legislative District, Urban Growth Area, County Level Census, County Division, Minor Civil Division, Traffic Analysis Zone, Voting District, Local Block, Block Group, Tract, Census Bureau, Office of Management and Budget. VE designations for types of administrative territorial entities. Constituency District Precinct Riding Ward City Autonomous City Charter City Independent City Imperial City Free Imperial City Royal Free City Capital Federal Capital County Administrative County Autonomous County Consolidated City County Metropolitan County Non-Metropolitan Viscountcy District Capital District City District Federal District Indian Government District Land District Metropolitan District Non-Metropolitan District Military District Municipal District Police District Regional District Rural District Sanitary District Subdistrict Urban District Municipality Direct Controlled Municipality District Municipality Mountain Resort Municipality Neutral Municipality Regional Municipality County Resort Municipality Rural Municipality Specialized Municipality Prefecture Autonomous Prefecture Subprefecture Super Prefecture Praetorian Prefecture Province Autonomous Province Overseas Province Roman Province Region Administrative Region Autonomous Region Capital Region Development Region Mesoregion Microregion Overseas Region Special Administrative Region Subregion Reserve Biosphere Reserve Game Reserve Indian Reserve Nature Reserve State